All right, well, we are going to live up now. We can get to predictions later. We are right back into it, so this best of three will decide the whole thing. No more comeback needed. This is on even footing, guys, so let's have a great end to it. Hopefully, this is as exciting of a Gully Wash game as we possibly can have. Gully Wash. I'm going to stop complaining about the map now, and we're just going to get into it. We do have Mix Up on the blue side and Quantic on the red. Remember, we casted that scrim on Wednesday, Justin. Quantic 5-0 the experiment. So this is a map that they probably feel okay on, at least. So let's see how that plays out. Banny, again, really solid mids on this as well. He's able to stay far enough away from those scouts. But CB is going to go down right off the bat. Banny and Mackie combined into Harblue and Platinum. Clockwork, actually, on the Harblue. Only Banny remains. He's going to try to get out of there, but he's going to go down. A lot of guys really hurt on both sides, but in the end, it's going to be a mid-win for Mixup, but both medics are dead.
Yeah, and we saw Mixup demolish the experiment on this map yesterday. Relic a big part of that, I believe. So we can expect that. And right there, we saw Mixup coming out of the gate hot. And if you're Quantic right now, you might be feeling the pressure. You just dropped the best of three when it looked like it would go in your favor. Three really close matches, and now you lose in middle in convincing fashion. You got to make sure if you're Quantic, you don't let this get in your head.
Yeah, I mean, we saw the momentum swings both ways. So, all right, Sigma, what do you think about this matchup on Gully Wash? Maybe just a quick prediction. We saw them win mid, but that doesn't say much between these two teams.
Yeah, I think Mixup actually snuck a free win out of mid because they actually went choke with their entire team except for one scout, I believe. So that's a surprise, and they took very little entry damage because of that, but I don't think they can get away with that too many more times before, you know, Banny clues in. I think Quantic will have this map normally. I think they would be better on this, but I have to keep in mind the fact that the last half of Gully or Greenery there was 5-1 for Mixup, yeah. So Mixup definitely has the momentum on their side and is showing it coming into mid. I'm still going to predict for Quantic on this one, but Mixup definitely going to take at least their share of rounds here, and here they come with a push along the flank now.
Yeah, they're going to go push flank. It's something that they really like to do on a lot of maps, but Banny is ready for him, of course, with stickies and a lot of spam. I don't know if anyone got actually into behind. I don't think they did, so Tyrone and company is waiting for that. They're actually going to look to push choke as well. I'm sorry, push flank as well. Choke, of course, will be the left side by the health pack there where the scout Sizer is peppering away. He's going to fall back now, so one did fall down, but that forward spawn's going to get him back in the fight pretty soon. And Justin, we're going to see some stalemating here. Shocker on Gully Wash.
Yeah, I mean, you know, this is the last best of three. There is no safety net for either team anymore. Teams are going to have to play it. Sure, we do see the bomb come in from Relic trying to get something working there. CB does not pop, staring into the face of danger. He did drop to the last Relic bomb on Greenery, but there he does not pop. And now we're back to the stalemate. One pick, not quite enough to make anything happen to push back out into middle on the Gully Wash. I guess I'll start saying it too.
No, I think so I should be the only one to say it, because I don't want people to, like, really hate themselves in their lives. It's like, listening to idiots, like, so we're just waiting for teams to do stuff here. Sigma, what's the plan here? I mean, how do you want to push? Have we seen a lot of teams try to sneak someone into that flank side, try to maybe take over house? Is that what you look to do? We do have Mackie running sniper, by the way.
I do like the flank push because of all the area that you get from it. Now that they've seen Mackie on sniper, I would just go, since,
he ran all the way back to switch, too.
Yeah, like, during this entire time he's running back, they managed to get a kill on Clockwork, so now they definitely want to get in there. And looks like that's what they're going to do. Uber on TLR coming from the flank. CB pops in response, but the first frag is found onto Sizer, so it's looking bad for Quantic's defense here. Tyrone manages to pick up a frag, but presence on point goes to Mixup, and now Quantic on the back foot. Tyrone getting picked off, trying to retreat to last, so they might roll this forward. Actually, Herb goes down to Mackie, nice bomb into the lobby there, but Mixup going aggressive into last. I don't think they're going to be able to get it with the spawns, but maybe they are. Pressure on point. Banny coming out with the stickies, not quite in time. Wow. First cap goes to Mixup.
So, Justin, we saw just a couple picks, and that really what cost him was Mackie running away. That was really odd. He went sniper and then went back, and that pretty much cost him the round. I mean, he did pick the medic, but at that point, it was an easy 5v6 push.
Yeah, I mean, once they lost that scout and Mackie was out of the fight, it was a no-brainer to Mixup just to push in there, and they're going to be so good at taking those advantages to the best of their ability every time. Right now, we see Relic coming out big on middle, taking out Banny. That's the first kill, so I'm you know what I'm going to say? Quantic's not going to win this. Two more are going to crumble. Three more are going to crumble. There's only two up. That's Clockwork and CB for the Quantic team, and once again, in convincing fashion, not losing a single member of their team, Mixup wins middle.
All right, I'm getting word from our other streamer, Greg, who's going on orange right now, that the maps were picked from the remaining pool, so they couldn't go back and do the same ones again, which I guess is good. I didn't want to see Snake Water, so.
Right.
I'm not sure which team picked this one. I'm assuming Mixup did because Quantic got first pick last time. But in the meantime, they were able to cap second Spire. Both teams do have Uber, so there will be a defense. Mackie's got his holiday wrench banging away on a gun there, which is just adding to the fun that is Gully Wash last. And we're going to see how this plays out here. Really hard push, like we've said a million times here, guys. So maybe we'll see some more submarine Michael Phelps action.
Yeah, and you're going to need an entry frag or baiting a scout to get over aggressive and pick him. And I think you can definitely do that with the Quantic scouts. If they don't pick you first, which Sizer does to Relic, and if Quantic sneaks up and gets another pick here, they're going to be able to push out with that gun guarding last, but it doesn't look like anybody's moving to do that.
Yeah, I mean, like we said, it's really easy to wipe a team trying to push into your last, so I think a lot of teams electing, even with a pick, you know, you don't want to risk losing, as Mackie's just playing the fun game of sitting in there waiting for his gun to die so he can switch off to heavy or something and kill everybody, so. It's really, really hard to do that when spawns are that close, so. By the way, guys, I forgot to mention, this is, in fact, the first ever second best of three in our LAN's history, so. This is cool. This is uncharted grounds for both of these teams.
That is cool, and it's likely to go to another three, right, between the way these teams have been playing.
Oh.
Just a sure skill here, and now we're just stalemated. Well, we do have Relic on Sniper, by the way, which I think is a good decision. Clockwork's on Sniper, too. A little bit of Sniper v. Sniper action. I always like to see that.
No one's trying to work that far left side for the attacking side, trying to do the summary, but Clockwork gets out-sniped. The body shot, hello, and goodbye. Justin loving that body shot action there. That's going to probably be enough for them to go, but look at that Uber just getting pushed out before they even get in the door. The gun is still up. Mackie's just going to check the beat. He's going to get ripped his head off by Relic. Clutch shot. Pulling his Mackie shoes on there. Dave's Moose onto Sizer. He's going to go down. Wow, three return. Platinum and Harblue. They're going to pressure the point. Can they get it? No. There's still a Tyrone. Shoddy. And Tyler. Tyler with CB and a Tyrone. What a play by TLR. Three for the win. That is unbelievable. Big play by Tyler.
Yeah, and Relic had a triple kill on last. He was able to take down a sniper.
They got all six between the two of them.
Yeah, so great play from the two soldiers coming out big. And who says Relic can't roam? Show me his versatility with sniper there out.
Yeah, so I'm not sure if someone knows for sure if this was in fact Mixup's map or not, because I mean Quantic was pretty good. Bandy's gonna get shut down right away. Platinum for the Enigma domination with the pipe onto him. Wow, and Mackie's gonna go down as well. They're not even gonna get out the door here, Sigma. Man, Quantic does not look like the same team that we saw earlier. Looks like they've lost all momentum.
Yeah, I think right now, if you're Quantic and you see Banny lose at middle, your best bet is to back out of middle. I'm saying it all day, and it's true. You can't win middle without Banny, especially when he's the first pick going down. And CB might even go down here.
As
we have Moose right now. He took out Tyrone, and he tried to get onto CB. The Clockwork's going to take him down. Relic's going to come in and take down CB anyway, though. It's not even going to matter, and the blue Uber is popped in the lobby. And now here comes Ink the Last, the tail ends of the Uber, trying to get as many kills as possible. We have TLR and Relic both getting on the point. Mackie meets him with a rocket, and it's all mixed up so
far.
Wow. All over the point, and that's a quick one.
Look at the scores, dude! Mackie with 5, and everybody else 4-4-3-3. Okay, everyone on the other team with double digits. That is like an invite team scrimming an open team or something. Pretty crazy, pretty scary if you're Quantic. They don't have much of an answer here.
I'm getting word, Alex, that from Grills that this was Quantic's pick.
What?
Yeah, so this Gully is Quantic's pick, and a bad pick by the looks of it.
Wow, that is really bad news. I don't know if there's a pause going on or something here. But Mixup, guys, to their credit, they were down big. I mean, what was it, 4-2 or something on Granary, and they brought it all the way back. They just found a new level of play, and they're going to go for it here, as Enigma and company are going to let that blue side completely push out here. Kind of a weird one, but Tyler and Relic starting to really just play so well. CB is in a lot of trouble, that blue side, but he's going to just barely make it out so far. And they're not going to be able to do it. They're up 3-2 as far as frags go. Beanie with another pipe kill on the plat. They're going to walk up there. I think Justin Quantic's going to be able to take this middle, but Harbaloo is still alive. He's running back. He's all the way back at his last. So
yeah,
maybe
we see
a
scout right
defense.
Now. He's running around on middle. Finally, Banny takes him down. That's Enigma. So slippery, as Tyrone would say, running around the nipple. of the middle point. But CB with Uber Harvey was just building it up at 90%. He's going to get it. Benny sticks in very quickly, and he's locking out a scout and a soldier. Lots of damage, forces the red pop. CB also pops right now. A lot of chaos going around. Benny gets taken down by Tyler Shotgun in the skybox. The Benny, Tyrone kills demo. Platinum, so there are no demos for either team, and most of the kills right now going in, well, actually it's tied off. Two down for Quantic, and now three down for Mixup.
Oh, the Uber Saw came out just for a second for Harbaloo, just like a little, like, I'm gonna get you once with this and run away. But CB's gonna go down, so both medics are down. Big scout fight, Clockwork starting to win some scout fights 1v1. Tyrone is trying to come back here. Relic over to drop Mackie. He's got the original, he's trying to make it happen. He's gonna be able to DM Tyrone, maybe, at 10. Yes, he's with the help of this scout. You know, so some nice kiting, equalizer work, the stick of speed, Justin able to kite around, and he's gonna be all right.
Yeah, spawns are up for CB, so he got the middle spawn. He'll be there with Banny and his scouts to try to defend this oncoming onslaught for Mixup as they are showing some presence there at the lower flank, and they're going to shove right in. All of them are jumping in. That's TLR. He's on the point, but he's very, very hurt. Now we have Platinum spanning up. Banny takes some damage, but he's going to return the favor onto TLR and take him down. Relic's going to bomb him and kill him. So there's two down for both teams right now. CB with 40-50%. Harbaloo equal Uber right now in the middle fight. Just chaos as most of the kills right now going into Quantic's favor.
Yeah, and Harbaloo's going to go down four straight for Quantic. So they found some of that energy they lost there, and they're going to be able to run this back all the way to second little mini spire thing too here. You're going to be able to get this, and CB is going to have a big advantage. Sigma, you're still with us, right? You crashed out, I think, but you're back.
Yeah. A body shot crashed me, and now I made it back in, but looks like Quantic in a good position to move to last here. They got the Uber Enigma on the signature Enigma Pyro. Let's see what he can do. He's blasting Tyrone into the wall. Not much happening with this Uber yet, but they switched to a scout. Harbaloo goes down to Banny. Banny also killing TLR, and looks like Moose on heavy somewhere. He's dead. Relic trying to hide to finish it, get some kills here, but looks like Quantic manages to take a round.
All right, so it's 3-1. Maybe the tale of two halves, like we saw in Granary. Could that possibly happen? I mean, that just would be unprecedented between the two teams. One team just to run out 3-0, and the other team to come back, just like a mix-up dead on Granary. Maybe we can come back here on Gooey-Wow-Ouch. All right, so mix-up pushing all down through the flank side. Big bomb coming in from Relic. It's going way up into the skybox. It's going to do enough to distract this team to move it behind. CB is going to go down. Tyrone's going to go down. Tyler, though, Mackie with a bomb onto Harbaloo. Banny goes down. 3v3 now. Anyone's game. Clockwork versus Moose. Clockwork versus Moose and Enigma. He's going to have to go run and get the health. He's got a 2v1 scout fight, but he is playing really well right now. He might have a chance at this. Here goes the one scout in his face here. Could they possibly win this one? Clockwork! He gets chopped down at the very end, but I don't know if the spawns are going to come in time. Tyrone is coming in there. He's going to be able to find on the other side that scout. There's a soldier there now, so Ty's going to have to back off, but wow, what an action-packed mid-fight there.
Yeah, and the middle is capped enough into Quantic's favor, right? We're going to see a reset of the middle fight because they do have that little bit of time on the point. Both medics now arriving towards middle. CB and crew have the upper ground, and they have the upper hand as they get two entry frags. Tyler taking down Banny, but Sizer's going to take down Harbaloo, and the overpowered stick on to Tyler. Don't worry.
Moose is sneaking up on the medic right now. Yeah, Moose is on CB. He's got some damage. Oh, he's got him! Wow, both scouts. Sizer and Moose with huge plays. They're killing the opposite medic. Clockwork's getting on his medium-sized horse, and he's going to run over to second. Moose is happy with that frag on the CB, though. Both scouts making huge, huge plays in that round.
Yeah, we saw the both medics go down, and Harbaloo went down first, so he's going to spawn up with about 30% more. We see CB just spawning now, so it's going to be around actually 40%.
Crits for CB here.
Okay, so let's see how Banny works this crit here. Sigma, do you like crits on Gooey Wowsh? Seems like this area, this open area, it'll be pretty good unless the team kind of hides upper.
Yeah, I like it both pushing 4 and 5, actually. It's easy to just peek in, take your one shot, make them pop, and then run away. And, you know, if they don't have Uber, then it's just, you know, go crazy with your stickies, because there's all sorts of room to get the frags in. Actually, Harbaloo popping into choke, TLR goes down, but CB is whisked safely away and now has Banny with him, ready to go back in. But
do they go in right now, do you think? They must, I guess.
They might have to. I mean, it's 3 down, but here's the pop. What are they going to get? They get Moose. CB goes down after only a couple stickies. Banny manages to finish Platinum without the help of more crits, but I don't know if they can clean it up. It's just Tyrone, and he's a spawn. He's fighting a choke. He kills TLR, but now Tyrone walking into Enigma with a bop.
Tyrone.
I don't think he can win that.
Tyrone puts on his man pants.
Because it allows his scouts and the rest of his team to come up, and now they're going to recap. Hardwood did get the forward spawn for some of his teammates, and he does have the uber advantage, but Tyrone showing big, and actually here comes Mixup doing the same thing. They're going to come in big, too, and take the point right back.
Yeah, a lot of leapfrogging going on here. Both medics now are away, alive. Harblue is 65%, so he's going to have about a 30% advantage on CB, who's running back to his mini Spire here. So in the end, after all that back and forth, it's going to be Mixup with middle. They win this. They look good for the series, or at least for this map, which, again, is Quantic's pick. So I don't know if it is a pick. I guess we're getting conflicting news about that. Maybe the ESCA themselves were the ones who picked this. I don't actually know. But we are going to see the Uber popped up. Two scouts bring a hard run into that house area, trying to get behind. They've stuck off that Spire area, but all the whole team for Quantic is upper. There they come. They're going to pop their Uber now. They're going to have a chance to do a lot of damage. Tyrone on the plaid. He's going to try to save the rest of his team now from that Relic Bomb. Relic is going to try to get away. Gunboats, he's just able to come to so much damage, or go travel so far, so much area. And now, though, Justin, they're going to run in the middle here. No Demo, so they have a pretty good chance of making something happen here.
Yeah, Quantic is 6 strong, Demo strong. Harbour's got about 10%, 15% more of Uber, but there's Twonix definitely taking this point as they're all over it. And, yeah, I think they're going to reset here because they know Harbour's got more of an Uber advantage.
Yeah, well, Mini Spire is going to be defended now by Mixup. Looking at the Uber advantage, like you said, it's going to be pretty small. I don't think unless they really push it quickly, they're going to get it here. So a lot of back and forth. This is a really good round, Sigma. Anything that we're missing here? Here comes the pop on the middle. So they are going to try to get it. CB is going to get that Uber probably just in time. He's at 99. He's going to get it now. So he's going to have a chance to repush without an Uber to him. Kind of a little bit of a timing error by Mixup. And it might really cost them, guys. Banny and company just dumping the damage onto him right now. Just a scout remains, and Nick was going to get shut down. The combo is still alive, but Banny, yeah, he's going to leapfrog all the way behind him. He's going to be ready to just sandwich them in here as Platinum versus Banny now. Demo be Demo. The stickies are out, and now Platinum's going to get shut down. No heals from Harblue, and there goes Harblue. So Banny, of course, wins that fight, and they're going to be able to get second now, Justin.
Yeah, we do have spawners spawning up. Four mix-ups, so they'll be able to defend last. Enigma going heavy, which is just brutal. Maybe not as brutal as his Pyro, though, so maybe Quantic can, shed off a sigh of relief. They do have 90 or 80% Uber when it's all said and done advantage over Harblue, so expect them to push in with this advantage, and they need to get on that heavy.
Yeah, nice buffs going around from Harblue, so he gives his team the best possible chance of winning. Clockwork trying to submarine, but look, there's stickies there. Now here comes the Uber in on Banny and Tyrone, looking for a frag. Tyrone finds the heavy, and then it pauses.
Oh, boy.
Oh! It's a cool pause, though. Look at Tyrone and the heavy.
Yep.
He's gonna suddenly come back to life and kill. Tyrone's gonna go down though. I don't think they're gonna be able to get this push. Wow, Uber versus no Uber. Just so hard to make this pop work. That clockwork early frag for Platinum ended up being just huge. And now CB is gonna run away with only 10%. Harblue is gonna have it, and the mini Spire is definitely gonna be recaptured. So quite a round here, guys.
Yeah, this is crazy. I mean, last is just so hard to take. We can see right there with a heavy for the defensive team. They were able to defend it. Push out the second. We do have Mackie right now on sniper. Hasn't been the best decision for him so far this map. Let's see if he can get a
well, he
a
nailed the body shot onto Harblue just there, so it turns out it worked out. And now Quantic looking to retake the mini spire with their buffs on their pocket and no heals to speak of for Mixup. And yeah, Mixup's just gonna back up and try for another solid defense on last. Let's see if Quantic can do more with their Uber than they managed to do last time.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so they're going to push top left. Sorry, I'm reading the stream chat here.
Take a swig.
I had my water in one hand. I was like, oh, it's back to me. Alright, so here comes the Uber versus no Uber pop here. Mackie's still running sniper, though. He's going to get shut down. Clockwork returns on TLR. Uber all over the place, but here comes the heavy out of one of those little gullies in there. He's going to come in and drop tons of damage. And yes, they're going to be able to hold this off. Mix-up just so strong here. CB trying to live the dream. Is that 3-2-2 for Enigma with the heavy? All of them down. And again, you kind of want to wish that Mackie was a power class there. Maybe with that extra splash damage, they would have had it, Justin.
Yeah, and they need to run into that heavy with that Uber. The heavy's just chilling in the gully, as you called it, but in one of the added, a while ago it was added, little nooks on last that allows somebody to stay safe for a long time. That's perfect for the heavy who just wants to kite the Uber and then come out guns blazing. And he's doing that two last pushes in a row now. And look at this, now we have Mixup trying to push last.
But
Sires are going big, taking down Enigma and Harblue and Mackie with the headshot onto TLR. The tables have turned, and Quantic with a quick 3 kills. Banny finishing off Moose too, so 4 down.
Yeah, I didn't see where Sizer was, but he got all over him and dropped the medic and got a double there. Andy, I think he even lived. Yeah, he did live. So huge play for Paul. Super Sizer Justin's putting his cape back on. It fell off for a little bit there, but it's coming back.
Yeah, he had some faulty Velcro, but he got a new one and latched it onto himself, and now he's flying in the wind and it's flapping behind him. He's doing well.
All right, so let's see if they can finally get this push. CB's going to have Uber before Harbaloo is. He's got about a 40% advantage. Let's see if Quantic can let the Uber go in first and follow him behind it. Now, they do have a heavy, so Mackie has gone to heavy. I like that choice, Justin, a lot more. It's going to give him a lot of muscle pushing in here. Big Russian muscle. See if it works out for him. Actually, they're going to let the heavy walk in. They're going to pop on the heavy here, and he's just going to kind of walk in. I don't know about this one. Banny is going to follow in here. They're not getting any damage, though. The TLR is going to go down, but trades with Sizer. They're all submarining underneath the point, and they just drop down and get destroyed. So really questionable push there. I don't think it's going to work out. They still have guys in there. Sizer, Clockwork, trying to make something happen. He's fighting Moose one-on-one. Oh, the pistol got him. Wow, a great kill by Clockwork. He still has a 300 health relic, though. It's going to be tough. Here comes the submarining stick. The submarining stick. Oh, my God. He hit him once. Oh, my God. It was really close, but it's not going to work out. God, Sigma, that push just... You can't push a heavy in by himself. It's just not going to do enough burst damage to make anything happen.
Yeah, I was sure they were just going to use the heavy as a follow-up, but then they decided to Uber him in, and the entirety of their Uber was spent on the heavy just walking forward. Harbaloo not going to risk getting another body shot on him from Mackie. He pops just to clear the sniper line, which maybe is a little bit of a waste, but I think they're going to take two back because of it. Yeah, they have
Banny,
more...
Banny, what? He's got a pipe on the medic. The door switches a target for 5 straight hits. Oh, he's going to go down just barely missing, but that's going to be so much damage. How could Tyrone... No, he's going to get him just in the nick of time. The stick
is
out now.
One needle will kill him.
The one needle's going to kill him, but he's got the health back, and now he's just going to say go to last. I don't know if Ty's going to be able to get this. No, he's going to turn around. He needs to kill the medic, and there he goes. They run into each other. It's like, what's up, dude? He's going to take him down. So a weird little chain of events for Tyrone, but Harbaloo is going to go down. So now, we've said this like 4 times, Justin, this is their best chance here to end this round. They have to do an Uber versus no Uber win.
Yeah, they have to do it, but unfortunately, Mackie's still on Sniper, so they're going to need to look for that entry frag from him. It's more than capable to do it, but now they just have to wait for him to do it. And with the Uber advantage, they might not want to do that. They're going to have to use the Uber advantage, and if they push without that pick from Mackie, and he might go down right here to the scout, but now he's saved by his team. If they push without Mackie, it's sort of a useless class while that Uber's going off.
Platinum is defending Sigma that underneath. He does not want any Michael Phelps action tonight. He says, no, sir. And I think that's really helping them out because the rest of the team is just waiting for them to push in. They're able to kite behind the point, and it's really smart.
Yeah, the downside to it is he doesn't have a buff coming in here, but we'll see if it actually comes into play. Lots of damage coming up from the Uber. They managed to kill Moose and Harbaloo. Enigma already down to half health. Here's the stick, but Banny's Uber, the stick's not that strong. And now just a 3v3, Plat down to 4 HP, jumping at Banny with the melee, and nothing happens there. Banny nails a pipe coming from Plat onto Banny. Now it's just Mackie left.
What's he doing? Like if he was Soldier,
I just
they won that
wish
easily.
He was Soldier, yeah. Exactly.
Well, okay, I mean, we're not going to call... I mean, obviously, Mackie does Mackie stuff, but, you know, if you're a sniper and that push to last, if he's any class that does any damage... I don't think he did a point of damage, Justin.
No, and what happens...
No, there he goes!
He does
some stupid.
Heavy, though, so, I mean, obviously, when we're about to rip on him, he does something good, and Clockwork can take down Relic, too. All these caught, you know, stranded on island right now with 36 HP. He's going to go down, and this should be the cue for everyone to push in. This is kind of what happened last time. It's why Mackie's on sniper. He hasn't died since he switched off and tried to defend, too. And he's just been caught on sniper, and fortunately, like I said before, with the Uber, he didn't do much. But here comes Quantic, and Enigma's going to take down Tyrone, but Banny with a pipe onto Platinum's going to get out of the point.
Oh, my God!
Hits him with the underpowered stick to win the round.
Banny, that's awesome. We've seen that like 5 or 6 times, just 3 or 4 or 5 straight pipe hits, and it's just, that's just great. It's great. And he uses Mouse Excel, by the way, guys, so... It's quite impressive. Justin, please take away mid while I pray to the Lord of Banny.
Yeah, well, you go ahead and get on your knees and pray to Banny right now. We see all of Quantic and Demo and Soldier, except for the combo, they went top. They have the upper ground, but now the teams are sort of mirrored right now. Platinum strikes first with the kill on Clockwork. Mackie taking down TLR, so both teams down one. CB and the rest of Quantic very hurt. They're going to start bleeding members, and they do. Mackie goes down. Banny's still very hurt, and CB is just hanging on for dear life. They got to back it out of
there.
Yeah, and it's just Banny goes down, so Clockwork's going to spawn up. Uber's going to be conserved, Alex. They're going to be equal, but certainly a strong win for mix-up on middle.
Yeah, I missed the time left here. I'm going to do a quick read scan. What is it, about 12 minutes left or 13 minutes, something like that? So 2-3 in favor of mix-up still, but remember, if they tie it up, this will go on. So Quantic is in trouble here at their last, but they do have Uber to defend Sigma. Banny, though, just amazing. I mean, the guy is just having the best LAN I think we've ever seen.
Yeah, it's absolutely ridiculous. Like, he single-handedly won that last round after his team, you know, kind of got beasted by Enigma. But anyways, here's the Uber coming into last. Frag is going down on both sides. Not clear who's going to win this. Mix-up probably going to repush. Moose coming up from underneath. He's on point, but Banny's too smart for him. He's got stickies there already. Enigma goes down.
And... oh, the repush from Platinum from the top.
Plat, huge.
That might do it, actually. There's still three left. Medic is still there. Clockwork got one. There's still Tyrone and Mackie alive. They have to take care of Tyler. They're going to be able to do it. Relic is still, he's out sort of in that catacomb area between the two. He's going to jump for the point, but he's not going to be able to get it. He's going to drop Mackie. He's got the stick. That's a hit of a stick in the head. Sizer's all of a sudden in the deep red after getting stick there, Justin. It is still legal, buddy.
Yeah, and he was about a millisecond away from that second swing, which would have killed Sizer, and I might have had to disconnect it after that kill, if that would have happened, but luckily it did not, so I'm still here as the rest of Quantic are trying to push out, but Mixup's not going to let him take it easily. Clockwork's going to take down Enigma, but the rest of Mixup are still here. They're not getting out yet. Mixup, Tyler kills Tyrone, and Relic kills Banny. Sizer and Clockwork going big, though, taking down Harbu and TLR, but most of the frags are going in Mixup's favor.
Mackie only with one big up. Bomb double. It's now right actually now. Roamer v. Roamer, Justin. Mackie versus Relic. The battle of the gunboating soldiers. Oh,
Spire
Mackie
King.
Gets him to crater, but Enigma's going to run in here in a little bit to end that fun. Mackie is going to turn tail and get out of there, wait for his reinforcements, but you never really see the Roamer v. Roamer stuff, and, you know, they did get the point, so a big play by Mackie. I thought they had a still cap, but they in fact got it, so Mackie's going to stop that shenanigans right there, and now Quantic's looking to repush mid.
Yeah, here they come. The Ubers are about leveled off, and we see that push out of flank led by Banny, but after losing both Tyrone and Clockwork, Quantic's going to have to back it up, maybe get up to the high ground. Mix-up not going to misstep this. They're going to come right in and take the point away from Quantic. Quantic's actually just going to have to get to their last build Uber and try to repel another onslaught.
Tyrone with two dominations leading the scoreboard. I think he's having his best round or best half of a map so far at this land. So maybe Tyrone finally starting to wake up. We do have Mackie running sniper in the back of spawn. I don't know, maybe an NG play. He had enough time to get a gun up here. Looking at the Ubers, both teams do in fact have it. So there will be an Uber versus Uber fight on the last. Sizer is going to go heavy, so he's going to get ready to bring the pain. It's so hard to push this last point here. We haven't seen Mixup try too much. See the delay push last time, Sigma. We'll see if they try something like that again.
Yeah, Relic going down, so maybe a cue for an off class here. I didn't see whether that was like meant to lead in or if it was a intentional suicide for a bomb. But Heavy would be good, Sniper might be good, just something to, you know, break it up a bit. We have Mackie sniping for Quantic. He's got a line up on the right side, and Sizer playing Heavy. Is he in that same nook that Enigma was using? I'm trying to find him.
I think Sizer. He's in that left side,
he is.
Yeah. Smart play, you know, he lets all the ammo be used on other stuff, and then all of a sudden you have a 300 health super Russian trying to kill you, and you just don't have any ammo to do on him, so.
Yeah, so meantime, here's Relic back as sniper, trying to make a pick, but there's a lot of spam on him, so he can't get a shot off.
Justin, where do you want to snipe if you're in the, I've never really seen the sniper find a good, is that the best spot, just trying to peek through those little windows?
Well, you gotta stay mobile, actually, when you know there's another sniper. You can't stay in one spot. And you gotta peek, and the way Relic's playing sniper is he's charging up to 150, and then he's just peeking corners and trying to, you know, hit whatever he can hit. And that's sort of, a ninja style of sniper. Not the most amazing to watch, but certainly effective. And last time he had 3 kills with it. And that's what he's gonna do. He's just gonna keep moving around, getting full charges, and seeing if he can tap somebody down.
Yeah, I mean, he's working around, trying to do exactly what you say. It's tough, though, because everywhere he goes, he runs into a lot of spam. Unlike Granary, those different areas aren't that far away, because you can just kind of turn your attention quickly.
This is my favorite spot, the one he's in right now, because you can get a full charge, and the combo likes to hold up there. And right now, Banny's holding up there. If he can get Banny, he's going to have a good opening for his team, but the scout spots, and he's forced back.
Yeah, but like you said, he's being mobile, just running around trying to pick a spot. I like that stuff out of him. So no frags in the last minute or so. Relic's going to go top left now, trying to find a different spot. So showing like he really knows what he's doing as sniper. Maybe not as much experience as the other snipers we've seen so far this LAN, but he's doing his thing. It's like he's looking for something, but he's going to get just eaten alive by a Mackie rocket, and Mackie's going to trade with him, but Tyler's going to go down as well. I don't know if
CB
I heard
did
of
pop.
An Uber pop. Yeah, that's Uber pop. Both Ubers popped up top right now. CB's going to have to get on his horse and get out of there. He's going to do that back into lobby. I don't know, they look like Clockwork trying to sneak out, but he's going to get shut down. And CB is going to get shut down by Moose. This could be devastating as far as Quantic's chances here. Sizer's going to go down, so, oh man, unless Banny can work some of that long-haired magic, Justin, this one looks like it could be over.
Yeah, just two up. Now we have three up for the Quantic team, but we have five coming in strong for mix-up right now. There's a bunch of damage being put out. Tyrone and Banny taking down two, but Relic's going to take down Tyrone, thankfully, for Quantic. Banny's still up somehow. There's a bomb on him. NCB. CB gets thrown up with, was that?
Wow.
4 HP. Survived somehow. He had 4 HP. He landed, and he buffed himself back up to 7 with the regen. A huge turn of events. That could have gone either way, but thanks to the TF2 gods, CB's a lot.
Sigma, just the power of that random low timer on the respawn just really saved Quantic, and they got out there and saw overextended red, and they just killed him.
Yeah, and I have to give credit to Mackie on that play with a nice air shot on some soldier, I don't remember who, but that is what saves CB. He didn't let him get a second shot, he just picked him off the roof. And now we have the push coming onto middle. Platt's already down, so Quantic taking a lot of ground here and looking to keep going. They got the Uber advantage, they got the player's advantage, so here's Tyrone jumping in, doesn't find anything, but Mix-Up is just getting the heck out of there without Platt to contribute damage. They know that they can't fight. Quantic's still chasing this. I think
they might get it right here, guys.
Yeah, Mix-Up will probably get this Uber, but if they get right on Hardly...
Oh, Tyrone showing up the ceiling, but he got him!
Oh, 96!
That's a big, big play. Banny's in there now. We could see a tie game, guys. Clockwork's in. They're doing all kinds of damage. There's the heavy. They still have a good chance of defending this, even those two. Now they're going to get chopped down, and there it is. 3-0 right back at you. The tale of two halves. Unbelievable stuff, Justin.
Yeah, ran what a heartbreaker back. From coast to coast. Great job from Mackie, as Sigma said, and Banny, of course, and Tyrone at the end, taking out Harblue. Just 4% left on that Uber would have changed the complexion of the whole match. Now we're tied up 3-3, so take it away, Alex.
7:33 remaining, 3-3, with plenty of time to finish this one out. Remember, we're going to 5 here. Moose gonna get shut down right away. Look how fast the Quantic guys are. Banny is just so quick, and he's got 2, he's got 3, another pipe kill. Oh my god, just fumbling around them. Only Harblue remains, but they're definitely going to try to chase him. He's only at 44% Uber, by the way. Oh, he's going to try to go for Martha Saw, but he's going to just surf a meat shot back to his spawn. He's still getting pressured by Clockwork. Can Clockwork finish him? Yes, he got him at the very end. Wow, but look at the Quantic guys. They're all over last. Might be a little too fast, guys.
Yeah, but they were good enough to make sure that they got out and didn't take damage from the spawning players. Now they can reheal and go in with that 100% against a no medic. It's not even that they have advantage. They're fighting a non-medic. And two frags do go off for mix-up, though. I'm surprised about that. But Banny's in there to clean up along with Tyrone. Only Harblue and Moose up trying to do everything he can. Moose is on CB. He might get him. CB's got
the star out. Moose?
Now this could be another defense, Alex, as we see right now. It's just Tyrone in there trying to do everything he can. But no, the spawns come in again and allow an amazing defense.
Unbelievable. Moose just put on his cloak and a superhero, not cloak, superhero cape, and then maybe a cloak as well. Maybe he's a cloak and dagger superhero buddy. And that was big. So Moose, we've seen these guys make big plays back and forth. That was huge. So now Mix-Up's looking to push all the way back. They have a big Uber advantage, and they have a really good chance, Sigma, of taking mid. Both these teams know how to run it back, man. It just they get the momentum, and they don't stop.
Yeah, seriously. I can't believe that Quantic managed to, you know, fail that push with no medic against an Uber. That's ridiculous to me, but I mean, partially the extreme spawns of Vidoc. But anyways, here comes in the Uber from Mix-Up. They're jumping all over Quantic. Quantic says, okay, you popped, good enough, let's get out of here. Banny's still throwing some spam, but all the players caught in from Quantic are going down.
He's gonna snipe from the right. Oh, we saw the medic, but he's gonna go down. So another weird choice to go sniper in that spot, trying to pull a pick, but he's gonna go down. Doesn't mean that CB is going to have Uber, but with all of his guys down, I don't even know if they can hold this. Tyrone's going to try to push out here, but they're gonna make a move. Two scouts have already gotten good ground here. Tyrone's going to go up and try to fight them. He's going to force CB to pop on him. These scouts are doing quite a bit. They're going to sacrifice Enigma for a full pop and a lot of damage, so it's a good trade, Justin, for them.
Yep.
Clockwork's going to go down along with Sizer, so not good at all for Quantic. They're kind of melting around now.
Yeah, and Mix-Up just laid the trap. They knew that Quantic had the advantage, but they were down members, so they forced themselves in, they forced the pop, and they backed out. Now they have the advantage. Just classic leapfrogging, very well done from Mix-Up. Great play. Harvey's going to take down Banny, too. So when they have this Uber, they're going to be able to come in, demo strong. Platinum coming in, and they're going to take second relatively easy.
Yeah, Platinum making sure no shenanigans, no one's waiting to try to bomb out of a weird corner. Doing a ton of spam damage. There goes the Uber. They're going to try to go in there. I don't know. It might be a quick pop. Harbu's gonna jump in as well to that upper. Tyler going big. Oh, he got Mackie and just barely stayed alive. So that aggression from TLR. Just always in your face, doing a ton there. Big scout fight on the right side. In fact, Clockwork is just going crazy, trying to kill Platinum. He's gonna get shut down.
Where's the combo?
With
Where's
two
the blue
pistols.
Pop?
Wow, and there goes the blue pop. They're gonna be able to stop the point. Big popped up in the air. No, the Uber's not enough. Great play by Tyler, popping him up in the air. They're gonna win that round. It's gonna be 4-3, Justin, in favor of Mixup.
Yeah.
And I don't know how much time's left. I think probably about 5 minutes. So
coast to coast again, only with the other team. Huge misstep though from Quantic. They tried to wrap around their combo. Meanwhile, the entire Mixup team was top right, and there was a scout up there who knew that. So breakdown in communication for the Quantic team. But here's middle this time around. Let's see. We have a bomber coming in. The first kill goes to Tyler on Sizer, but Clockwork reciprocates, killing down Relic. So now another kill from Enigma onto Tyrone. Quantic loses another. That's Clockwork. And CB gets a needle kill. Syringia later onto Enigma. 4 down now. Only CB alive. 5 down from Clockwork.
That's not good for them. I mean, they have to win this round to tie it up before a clock runs out. So Mixup, I don't know if they're going to go into that defensive mode that we saw earlier out of Quantic. I hope they don't, as I want to see some more action, but I definitely can't blame them. Sigma, what do you do in this position if you're the red side? Are you just going to kind of slow down and make them push on you, or what? I guess there's still probably enough time to not do that, but...
Yeah, I think I would take the 4, and then I might stop it, because there's, as of right now, there's, like... 3 minutes and 5 seconds left or something like that. And yeah, Quantic's feeling the pressure. They're going to Uber in, but Sizer goes down early. TLR is going through. He eats a sticky trap from Benny, though. Get a few kills onto Quantic, but Quantic can't win this first. I think this is it.
Yeah, only Banny remains unless he's put up one of his magical sticky traps somewhere. He's reloading a ton of stickies, so they might be somewhere. I don't know, as he's going to roll in there. They are on the point there. I don't think anyone's going to try to cap from down there, so that last gasp for Banny, he's got the stickies blown away by the heavy. They're going to hold this. They don't even really need to push here, Justin, but they might. But we've seen it be pretty hard to accomplish this push, even in the best circumstances for both teams, so... I don't know what the call is here. Sizer trying to make something happen. He goes down. We're going to see if Quantic has another rabbit they can pull out of a hat here.
Well, they're going to try to do a sort of pseudo forward hold. Although Mackie's going to go down the Platinum. And with Sizer already down, this should be cue for Mixup to get in there. But with that heavy, it looks like they're just going to stalemate on top of the wooden spire and sit there and just wait for Quantic to try to mount an offense. They do have the Uber now, so I guess we're going to find out if they're going to push it all or just chill.
And look,
there's
at Enigma,
a minute 30
just,
left.
Yeah, a minute 30 left. Enigma's pumping full of damage. Everything that tries to look at him. Running out of bullets, he's done so. He's fired that gun so much. Overheating in his hands. Clockwork is going to go down. I don't think this looks good at all for Quantic. They're going to have to wipe them here somehow, even though Harblue actually doesn't have Uber, so this is their best chance to do it right now. Tyrone is going to try to get on his horse and catch as many as he can. Banny is going to go down, but Mackie able to get Harblue with the help of Tyrone. He's going to go down, though. Mackie, they need to cap Spire. They need to defend last. It's a stick. Is it Relic on last to Tyler? They snuck around. We were watching the forward play. They were able to kill Harblue, but in the end, that's a GG. 5-3. On Gullywash, sorry, on Gullywash, and now we're gonna go to Warmfront. A fun game, but in the end, that first half was too much to come back from.
Yeah, you can't go down 3-0 on a map, or 0-3 on a map that you choose. Yeah, and expect to come out with victors. It's not gonna happen. It was a valiant effort on the part of Quantic to try to do just that. Mixup too strong, too good of a team, just solid all around. They're not gonna let you wipe away their 3-0 deficit. And now we go to Warmfront, Sigma, where, you know, it's another stalemate-y last point, and a map where we've seen Quantic do rather well on. Banny was kind of the pioneer of demo rollouts on that map, got there very quickly, and that was his secret weapon back 2 lands ago or 3 lands ago when the map was picked by them. But now, apparently, the idea was that, or we're getting word that Mixup had chosen Warmfront, and if that's the case, then maybe, you know, Mixup's feeling rather strong. What do you think, Sigma, we're going to see on Warmfront?
Yeah. I'm not actually sure how much choice there was in these map picks, because, I mean, if they vetoed Stand-In and G-Pit, and then they have to play 6 maps, like, there's only 6 maps
left.
But
don't you think someone would agree on Badlands, then?
Well, I think Badlands might end up being the tiebreak, then.
Right.